Hello students, welcome to EPG Pathshala. I am Dr. Beena Antony Reggi, Associate Professor at Aditi Mahavidyalaya, University of Delhi. We are today going to learn about community engagement and youth. The learning outcome: the student after going through this module will learn meaning of youth, the youth in India, youth development, and understanding to community engagement, the forms, process, benefits, and principles of community engagement, and the role of youth in community engagement. An introduction to the topic: the youth of any community is the most creative, energetic, excited, inventive, and dynamic section of the population. Youth has the energy, passion, motivation, and interest. Thus, they are the valuable resource of the community, bringing in change and development to the community. The youth promote economic, cultural, socio, and political growth to a community. A community's capacity to develop depend on the volume or percentage of their youth population. If we are able to make use of the youth power of the community, the community can develop and progress many folds. The youth are the imaginative, digital leaders, bringing in the innovation, contributing to the newer trends, and changing the community. The youth are also sensitive to sustainable development. They are also conscious about protecting the environment. Thus, if we invest in the youth by motivating them, developing them, channelizing them, we can foster positive change and development in our communities. We have also heard how, in the present times, the youth energy is being used in destructive ways. There is violence on the street, juvenile crime is on the rise, increase in substance abuse and wastage of life, unwanted pregnancy, high school and college dropout, rise in mental illness among the youth. This could be because the family and community structure is not able to protect and promote youth as it used to. Thus, there is a need to identify this youth energy again and channelize it to community development by community engagement, which would also lead to constructive and positive change in the overall development of the youth. We need to guide the youth to work towards building up the community and the nation at large. Youth in India. According to 2011 census, India is the second most populous country in the world at 1.21 billion after China, that has 1.34 billion persons. India accounts to 17.8% of the world population. India's youth population in 2010 was 35.11%, and since then there is a downward trend. By 2020, it is expected to be 34.33%. It has been observed that in many growing economies and developing countries, there is a demographic transition. Children escape the deadly illnesses and reach the youth stage, causing an expansion in the youth band of the population pyramid, which is popularly called the demographic dividend. This is also the time to take advantage and maximize the economic growth. India at present is in this advantageous stage as compared to other countries in youth population. India is younger than China and Indonesia. Today, India, China, Indonesia contribute to 68% of Asia's population, and Asia contributes to 60% of the world population. Youth development. Youth development means obtaining the skills, competencies, attitudes, and values required to be a successful individual of the society. It is observed in various human development theories that an individual passes through various stages of life. In each of the stages, there are certain developmental tasks assigned to them. According to Erikson's psychosocial developmental, there are 8 stages from infancy to adulthood. In each of these stages, there is a psychosocial crisis which have positive or negative impact on the individual. The youth, according to their age, are in the fifth and sixth stage of Erikson's psychosocial developmental stage. In the fifth stage, the psychosocial crisis is between ego identity and role confusion. The individual is developing the virtue of fidelity. In this stage, the individual is searching for a sense of self and personal identity. The individual seeks interdependence and wants to seek their identity in the context to sexual and occupational aspect. In the sixth stage, the youth is in the crisis between intimacy and isolation and develops the virtue of love. In this stage, the individual explores long-term relationship and commitment outside family. Success in this stage is rewarded with family and love against isolation. Erikson in 1968 stated that these two stages are very important for the success in life, as if the individual does not form strong identity rooted in family, community and ideology, it will affect intimacy and stable long-term relationship in the individual's life. Erikson further stated that in these stages, the youth they live in, they are very important. Thus, youth development is the nurturing and excelling of the youth's ability to perform well in their personal, social, and professional responsibilities and to become a successful and healthy individual. In this virtue, the youth should be supported by all sectors of the community like family, school, college, faith organization, community governance and business or occupational agencies. Introduction to community engagement. Youth can play a very important role in community engagement. Let's try to understand what is community engagement. To begin with, what is community? Community means a group of people coming together due to them coming from a certain geographical location or due to them sharing similar interest or background or affiliation or identity or similar issues or problems. What is engagement? Engagement means a range of activities describing different interactions between diverse people in a group. The range of activities could include communication, involvement, consultation, collaboration, and decision making. Acting united in any formal or informal group of partnership. Thus, we could explain community engagement as a planned or conscious process with clear purpose with the groups of people who are connected due to their geographical location or similar needs or interest or affiliation or association to tackle their issues and problem. Community engagements are the range of activities that will better the group situation or solve the problems in the community. When we are talking about community engagement, we are talking about the larger group we live in. We are focusing on the betterment of the larger group we belong to. This means a change of focus from my needs to our needs, from my problem to our problem, from my betterment to our betterment. Thus, community engagement calls for a shift in emphasis. Community engagement may vary from situation to situation. Community engagement is a variety of activities like consultation, dialogue, communication, awareness, education, extension, and public involvement, participation, reaching a consensus, working in partnership, or in democratic principles. Kaveh in 2001 broadened the scope of community engagement to include government and citizen participation, which could involve mutual communication and deliberations between government and the public. This will mean citizens' involvement and ownership to all activities of the community. Forms of community engagement. Community engagement is a galaxy of activities at the community level. There are different forms of activities that are covered in community engagement. Some forms of community engagement that are taken up by government agencies or non-government organizations or faith-based organizations or voluntary organizations, these are informing. I would like to explain that. working at the community level, informing the community persons of the government policies and programs meant for the community development. For example, the Anganwadi worker under the ICDS program, Integrated Child Development Service, is involved as a rural mother in the community. Her role is to inform the community person about the mother and child's health issues so as to work for the better health among the mother and children in the community. Consulting. Working with the community, consulting them for their development. The community development program in rural India worked in the community level, working with the rural population, building their awareness and formulating program for their development with active consultation with the rural population. Involving. The community is involved through local governance like the Panchayati Raj, through a range of mechanism to ensure that issues and concerns are understood and considered as part of the decision-making process for the development of the community. Collaborating. Collaborating with the community by developing partnership to formulate options and provide recommendation. In India, there are the non-government organizations that work for the community development. The government collaborates with them to reach out to the community. Empowering. The community to make decision and to implement and manage change. In rural and urban India, government and non-government organizations promote self-help group made by women from the lower economic strata to form groups with various objectives so as to empower women of the community. Forms of community engagement. Community engagement is a continuous process moving from informing to consulting to involving to collaborating and to empowering. The process of community engagement. Community engagement would be a result of a situation when the community is faced with a challenge or the community gets together and plans for it. Own development or community engagement would also be driven by other stakeholders. But the process followed in community engagement is identifying a community need or issue that requires to be addressed urgently. The community will come together if there is an urgent need or issue to be addressed, a concern that is affecting most or large numbers of the community persons, an issue that needs urgent attention. This will cause the community to come together. Community persons living for many years together have to be brought together. For example, a break of an epidemic causes a crisis in the village that would cause the village persons to come together to work for a solution. Planning and laying down objectives. The community needs to have meetings, brainstorming, discussions, and polling to come to a consensus on what they want and how they need to achieve it. That is, the community needs to plan out their objectives for dealing with a particular issue. The community would also call in experts on the subject, have workshops to understand the issue better. For example, a village in Rajasthan in India, facing the problem of water scarcity, plans to develop rainwater harvesting program. For this program, the community comes together and plans out the mechanism they need to lay out. How many family in the village community needs to contribute to address water scarcity issue? Identify community leaders and task force. The community is a mix of different kinds of people. Some who are good in certain work, like there will be some people who are more vocal, some are silent, some good in organizational work, some good in grassroots work. Thus, it is important to assess the human resource and identify the potential leaders and build up a task force to initiate the community engagement and help achieve its objectives. Mobilize resource. In continuing with the community engagement, it is important to mobilize all kind of resources, human, money, material, and government support. Maximum community participation would achieve maximum result. Coordination and accountability. The community must be involved by regular meetings to help coordinate the work and also to measure the work progress. The leaders and task force must be accountable to the larger community. Regular monitoring will help the community engagement in their accomplishment. Feedback and evaluation. Feedback and evaluation is a continuous process from the initiation to the completion stage. Community engagement process is not complete unless all the community remain together in their endeavor. Regular open house discussions will keep the community together in the program they have started. Feedback and evaluation will help them in being focused in their objectives. Community engagement and its benefits. Community engagement will foster community development and nation building. It is important that we build up resilient relationships with different groups in our community. This would further build up mechanisms for building the community's strength and its ability to join with the government and other stakeholders in dealing with complex issues and change for the betterment of the nation. Community engagement is beneficial both for the government and the community people. Community engagement is beneficial for the government in various ways. The community, when involved in policy-making consultation, would contribute with better understanding and experience, sharing of a practical relevance and implementation, which would increase the quality of the policy-making mechanism. Youth would be involved with innovative ideas and suggestions. The community engagement would help to observe and suggest on the service delivery of government program. Thus, there is a monitoring on the effectiveness and efficiency of service delivery. Input can ensure services are delivered in a more effective and efficient way to the community. The government, through community engagement, builds up their relationship with the community. Understanding the views of the community towards the government. A government that does not go back to the community persons will be disconnected to the community needs and problems. Youth are the most forthcoming in the community and it's easy to access them and build a relationship with them. Youth are the future of the nation, so it is important to build up relations with them. Community engagement proves to be a platform for the government to check its credibility with the community. Government will get to understand its reputation and status. Community will be able to review the government's performance and help them to improve on their functions. Community engagement gives an opportunity to perceive any emerging unrest or dissatisfaction in the community. The government could take proactive steps to curb any unrest in the community. Youth are the face of the community and they are the first to react and agitate. They are the voice of the community, so youth can be the community's voice to the government. Community engagement thus proves to be an instrument of exchange between the community and the government. The government, through engaging with the community, also earns a reputation of being open, accessible, approachable, willing, and accountable to the community. Community engagement is beneficial for the community in various ways. Community engagement is the collective voice of the community. A well-planned and purposeful community engagement to solve a problem or address an issue will bring together diverse voices from the community, thus bringing more ideas and options to solve the problem and address the issue. In the community engagement process, communities could involve the government representatives and address government standards in the service delivered by the government. The government representatives could get a feedback of what is happening in the locality. Like the local government representatives could be briefed on the cleanliness in the community, on the Swachh Bharat mission, a government program to have a clean India and how steps could be taken to implement cleanliness in the locality. Community engagement will help the community persons dialogue on their issues and challenges and work out solutions. The community can recognize and prioritize their issue and challenges and make plans to work towards its solution. Community engagement will result in the ownership to the solutions to the issues and challenges or plan of action which the community persons have themselves arrived at. Thus, the community is part of the decision-making process and would take up the responsibility to achieve the goals they have dreamed of. When the community works together, the elders would have a relationship with the youth of the community, and the elders would motivate the youth to be their arms or their action force to deliver what they have planned for. Thus, community engagement unites the whole community together. Community engagement will further create a sense of responsibility, ownership, and belonging for all in the community, which will result in the community coming together and working for the overall development of the community on future issues. Continuous community engagement will ultimately lead to empowerment of the community, and the community will always be proactive towards their problems and developmental issue. The community empowered means the population is empowered. The nation with awakened and empowered citizens will be a progressive nation. Guiding principles of community engagement. Principles guide us in understanding and performing the tasks and achieving our goal. Principles of community engagement are the fundamental norms or ways of practically performing the tasks of engaging with the community. The principles help us to adapt the theoretical and practical knowledge to the situation we are facing while doing community engagement. According to Peth and Leach, some of the important principles required in community engagement are clarity of objective. One of the most important principles of community engagement is clarity of objective. The community engagement is only possible to be successful if there is a clarity of the purpose. Why are we wanting to organize the people together and working for the community? So it is important to first lay down the objectives and to see that the objectives are legal and ethical. Consensus. Community engagement involves a number of individuals of the community that also means many thinking minds. This could result in many ideas or ways of doing something, different procedures to reach a destination. This could mean differences of opinion. Thus, it is important to come to a consensus within the community. Consensus among the community persons in understanding the problem. Consensus how to deal with the problem. Consensus in the process to follow. Consensus on what would be the role and responsibility of the different persons in the community. Representativeness. Community engagement within any community would involve different groups of people. The different groups of people would be the woman, the elderly, the youth, the children, the groups with different religious backgrounds, or maybe the group with different economic backgrounds. It is very important that in the process of community engagement, there is a maximum representation of different groups of people. There must be a sense of inclusiveness in the community. For example, if the community is developing a recreational center in the village or a playground in an urban community, are the different groups of people consulted in the plot or building layout? Building relationship. Community engagement must foster building relationship between all groups in the community and other groups outside the community like the government or other stakeholders. There must be an open channel of communication among all groups so as to keep an open opportunity of growth and development for the community. Positive relationship builds relationship and keeps dialogue opportunities open to discuss everyone's concern and interests. Deliberation. The community engagement the whole process of consultation within the community, the discussion, the reflection, the mediation, the thoughts, the consideration, the contemplation, and how the community arrives at the decision is extremely important. Transparency. Community engagement must have high levels of transparency in the working within the community. There are collective decisions and collective working, thus everyone must be open to see results of the action taken. This will increase the trust levels in the community. For example, a village panchayat wants to develop a street lighting system in the village for which a certain amount of money is to be spent. The community must be involved to find out where the street lights need to come up. If after the completion of the installation of the street light, the community wants to know the cost of the project, the panchayat must be transparent to disseminate the information. Evaluation. The community engagement must evaluate their decisions taken and the effectiveness of the decisions. The community must at every step evaluate their objective of working, the procedures taken, the funds utilized, and the targets achieved. This evaluation will help their future course of action and their success and their future sustainability. So, what is the role of youth in community engagement? If we want to summarize this module, research in the area of youth and resilience have shown that youth from difficult and deprived environment can do well and grow into healthy adults if they are supported by encouraging families or community members. Youth in rural India take part in community engagement to build and develop their community. Youth could be encouraged by government and non-government agencies through various youth development programs to address the community need. It has been reported that youth ideas and energy is beneficial for faster decision making and developmental work when involvement in community engagement. The commitment levels of the youth are much higher. There is a reciprocal relationship between youth development and community engagement. Both are mutually beneficial to each other. If youth are involved in community engagement, they would grow in their personality and experience. For the community engagement too, youth population are much more active, creative, and responsible partners. There are a number of examples we have seen in the near past where youth have demonstrated that youth could take up responsibility and foster positive change in the society. For example, youth taking up a mission to clean the banks of River Yamuna in Delhi. Another group of youth is planting fruit trees in public places to fight against hunger and starvation. Youth are nowadays powered with weapons like social media, social action, and RTI, to name a few. Today, the government also realizes the need to involve the youth in community engagement. Thus, we see more and more youth in governance. We need to engage the youth constructively, and community service is the best place for it. Thank you.